Hello there, this is Delight Channel. Good to have you here once again this week. Last week we concluded our conversation on customer management, and like I promised, this week we are moving to something very new and which I think is very fundamental. And whether you are hearing this as an entrepreneur or you are hearing this as an individual, it's relevant to you. And what's that? That's the concept of change. So for the next couple of weeks, we will be speaking about change management. And why am I so excited about this? I think it's also coming at a very good point in the year. At this point, most people are already doing a lot of evaluation for the outgoing year and a lot of planning for the incoming year. And of course, one thing that is constant, that's why they say the only constant thing in life is change. So one thing you probably are already dealing with is this issue of change. What are we learning this year? How do we apply that into the new year? What needs to change? What needs to be changed? And it is necessary, therefore, that you pay attention to the next couple of videos. I see this running into the early part of the new year, but we'll see how that goes, because we just want to try and wallow in it a bit so that we illuminate all the corners. We encourage you to deliberately embrace change, because that is the only way you can survive. And that is why Charles Darwin said, it's not the strongest of the species that survives, nor the most intelligent, but the one most responsive to change. I mean, how do you explain it? When we watch all these cartoons and all these animations and we read about anthropology and what archaeologists are finding, they see a lot of fossils of very giant creatures with big jaws and big claws and big paws. And you begin to wonder, why are they now extinct? Simple. They were not able to deal with change. And therefore, if you too do not want to go extinct, then you need to really, really be deliberate and slow down to learn what change management is all about and build skills that helps you to achieve it. Have you ever seen the diagram or an image of the heart pulse? Yeah, you can see one on the screen right now. What do you find? Highs and lows and highs and lows. But when you see a man that just passes on and just dies, what do you find? The line becomes a straight line. That is exactly why you cannot afford to ignore change and how to handle it. Because the day you stop running from change, the day you start resisting change, is the day you begin to yourself move yourself towards death. Because I read something somewhere, I can't really remember who said this, but it's really, really pertinent. It says that to improve is to change, and to be perfect is to change often. So, I've just spent the last few minutes laying the foundation so that you know that this is big deal. And we will try and explore it both from the entrepreneurial side and from the individual side. And I'd like to again quickly recommend a book to you right now so that you can start reading, because towards the end of this series, we will dwell on that book and see what it has to teach us. And that book is Who Moved My Cheese? By Spencer Johnson. It's a very interesting book, very easy read. If you are on the Telegram channel, we will be sharing a copy of that book there. The only question you need to ask yourself as you read that very simple, interesting book is, which of these characters are you? And then when we come to do the debriefing, it will be very clear. So let's get into today's meat. What is change? It's a very well-used word, change, 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 change. It's been a popular mantra in the Nigerian politics over the last 4 years plus. So really, what is change? And if you just check the general definition of change, change is defined as an alteration to make different from what it was. Okay? So change is whatever you do to create a new situation, a new condition, different from what it was before the change happened. And when we talk about change, we are talking about you as an individual realizing that whether you like it or not, Every time, every day, every second, you have to contend with change because things are just going to change. There's nothing you can do about it. And change can be triggered from the internal or from the external. So, when we talk about internal change, we are talking about change that is driven by things that are inside the entity that we are talking about. If it's an individual, internal change, some are biological, you can't do anything about it. Every day that passes, you are getting older. Internal change can be because you have a new drive, you have a new dream, you have a new motivation, you have a new target, you have a new goal. Those things are internal to you, either as an individual or for your organization. On the external side, on the other hand, you may be forced to change because the variables around you are moving. It could be a change in government policy, it could be a change in the weather, it could be a change in the marketplace, and many, many changes have been initiated or caused by this disruptive technology that whether you like it or not, you have to respond to it. So, whether it is external or internal, change is something that is inevitable and that you have to deal with. And like I said, if you are going to stay alive, if you are going to keep growing, if you are going to keep improving, if you want to remain on top of your game, if you want to remain on top of the market, you cannot run away from change. If you don't change, you will get changed. I say that again. If you don't change, you will get changed because you are not in control of all the variables. So even if all you are trying to do is to hold on to the familiar and do your best to hold on to it as tightly as you can, there are forces outside you that makes it inevitable for you to have to deal with change. And therefore, the question then comes, what does this change entail? How can one identify the variables involved? How does one navigate one's way through these change management phases? What do you need? What do you not need? What is the mental state you need to be? All of that is what we will start unpacking one by one starting from next week's video. So I plead with you to please let's know what you think about what we've been doing. Very soon it will be 2 years, how time flies. And if you know anybody around who will benefit from this, please feel free to share. Like I said, we have a Telegram channel. Come on board, share your comments, show us some love, drop us some comments on this channel. And until next week, when I come and I take this conversation forward, don't ever forget that T-Mark is still my name. It's always a pleasure to have you here week in, week out, and I hope to see you next week. Thanks for being here once again, and see you next week. Bye.